Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Glad tidings from the Quran. We all talk about friends and friendships. The Quran tells us in this verse, Al-akhillau yawma idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen. All friendships will be severed, except those friendships and relationships that were based on taqwa, that were based on the pleasure of Allah. Now, we have to ask ourselves a question. What kind of friend am I? And what kind of friends do I have? Because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, Al-mar'u ala dini khalili. You will be upon the ways and you will be upon the habits of your friend, and that eventually can affect your belief and it could affect your actions and it could compromise or it could benefit your position in front of Allah. So a twofold question: what kind of friends do I have? Are they bringing me closer to Allah or taking me further away from Allah? And what kind of friend am I? Because otherwise we will regret on the day of Qiyamah. The Quran says, Ya waylata laytani lam attakhidh fulanan khalila. We will... Those who had bad friends, they will cry out on the day of Qiyamah, if only I did not take that person as a friend. Because of him now I have to suffer punishment. I have to suffer the consequences. But the glad tiding here is this, that the hadith Qudsi tells us, or the hadith tells us, that amongst the categories of people who will get shade under the throne of Allah on the day of Qiyamah are those two people who were friends for the pleasure of Allah. اجتمعا وتفرقا لحب الله. When they came together, it was in the pleasure of Allah. When they departed from each other, it was in the pleasure of Allah. Then such a friendship, it will continue in the year after. Look, otherwise, people will run from their own fathers and mothers, from their own brothers and sisters, from their own children and parents. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِي وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. But if you are friends in the pleasure of Allah, then it will be a different story. There's a hadith, I give you the crux of it. Ali radiallahu anhu mentions, if two people are friends for the pleasure of Allah and they encourage each other to become obedient servants of Allah, the one passes away in obedience. He's now shown his reward in the year after. He says, Oh Allah, my friend back in the world, keep him on obedience. Let him die on obedience so he can get the same reward because we were friends in your obedience. The flip side of that coin, if two people are friends in the disobedience of Allah, the one passes away. He now sees the punishment. He says, Oh Allah, that friend of mine's in the world, he used to encourage me to do wrong. So you keep him upon wrong so he can die upon disobedience and he can also suffer the consequence, the manner in which I am suffering the consequence. So the glad tiding is, be a good friend and have good friends. It'll benefit you in the year after as well. Then Allah tells us about the year after, the very next verse. Ya ibadi. Allah says, O my servants, la khawfun alaykum al-yawma wa la antum tahzanun. On this day, there will be no fear nor any grief for you. Now, fear and grief are two things. You fear over what will happen in the future. You grieve over what happened in the past. And every human is plagued with this to some extent or the other. But in Jannah, there'll be no fear over what will happen tomorrow and no grief over what happened yesterday. There'll only be bliss upon bliss. Allah will say, "Udkhulu al-jannata antum wa azwajukum tuhbarun." You and your spouses enter Jannah now, so you can be honored. And in Jannah, you'll be honored because they'll have... trays of gold and, you know, beautiful waiters and waitresses coming to serve you. And then Allah says, and this is the glad tiding, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِيهِ الْأَنفُسُ وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنُ. In Jannah, you'll get whatever your heart desires and whatever will bring delight to your eyes. Subhanallah. There is no person in the history of humanity, and there will be no person up to the day of Qiyamah, that will get whatever he or she desires in this world. But in Jannah, every inhabitant will get whatever they desire. Why? Allah gives another glad tiding. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This is the Jannah which you earned now because of the good actions that you did. So many glad tidings here. Do good actions, you'll get Jannah. If you get Jannah, you'll get whatever your heart desires. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. You'll see that in Jannah which no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and no heart had the ability to comprehend. There will be no fear, there will be no grief. But have taqwa and have the right friends. May Allah enable us to maximize on this glad tiding. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.